Welcome to another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. I have wanted to make one of these anoraks for years. I finally got around to it. Let me show you how I did it. It was a fairly simple project that surprised me on how quick it was to make. Stay with me and we'll get started. For a pattern for this project, I chose to go with a hooded sweatshirt, what a lot of people call hoodies. I bought this for $5 at a thrift store, and I kept trying them on at the thrift store until I found one that would go over my vest. You know, I got a lot of gear I carry in my vest. I wanted one that would fit loosely, fit comfortably over my outer garments. And so, in my case, I ended up with a triple X size sweatshirt, and that's this here. Now, some sweatshirts, their shoulders slope down, the design of the sweatshirt. And I purposely chose one that had straight shoulders, just to make this project more simple. Okay, I laid it out on my blanket. Now, let's discuss the blanket. This is an old wool blanket that I bought many years ago. It is 62 inches wide by 68 inches long, and I took this end, flopped it over. So here's the edges of the blanket, and up here is the folded edge, and that's how I laid the sweatshirt out on the blanket to cut it. Now I left about a half inch to 5/8 inch seam allowance all around the sweatshirt. And now when we get to the sides here, I left again about 5/8 seam allowance on the sides, but I carried it straight on down rather than tapered in, because I want to use the full length in this of the blanket for the anorak, and I don't want the anorak to be gripping my clothes. I want it to hang down loosely. Now, on these pieces here that we cut off, this will be our what we use to make the hood. All right, now I want to use what they call a seam ripper to take the hood off of this, the hoodie. Now that the hood is off, what I did was I took a piece of paper and folded it over, stuck it in the neck here, and put the fold right at the top of the neck and marked out the outline of the neck. And I will flip the sweatshirt over and do the same for the back. All right, here's my neck pattern, neck hole pattern cut out. And what I've done here was to lay out the blanket cutout and lay it out in half, fold it over in half. I took a permanent pin and I marked right here. Hopefully you can see that right there. And that's where we will lay this to mark out. Now, for the front, you can see here the line. That's where the shoulder seam should be. So to do the front, we will lay the line. We will lay this line right on here and right on here, with this right in that middle, right on that line. See, how am I going to demo that? Okay, there we go. I've got the center of the neck cutout centered on the center of the blanket. So now we'll mark that out, both front and back, and cut it out. Okay, here is the cutoff under the arm of the original blanket, and here is the hood. And I split the seams in the back, the seam in the back of the hood, so that it would lay out flat, and I could use it as a pattern. But the length from here to here was too long for this. So I took the two pieces and cut them off here, cut the angle off, and then sewed it together. And this is what I ended up with. And now, I laid this out on here. I gave this an inch and a half or so extra on the front, because once I sew the hood on, I want to be able to fold this over and then sew it again. That'll make the front of the hood a little more durable, a little more rigid. And I gave myself a little bit of extra seam allowance as well in the layout here. Okay, I am going to cut this off and sew it together. Cut the wool blanket, and then I'll take it to the sewing machine and sew it together. All right, here's the anorak all laid out back down. What I did was I put a mark right in the middle of the back. And here's the hood. It's all sewn together. So I need to install the hood on the anorak. Well, here is the very back of the hood. So what I'm going to do is I'll have to shove it inside, inside here, the whole hood, and put the seam here pointing upward and line it up with this, line this seam up with the middle of the back, and then also sew it on. I'll pin it on and then sew it. Okay, here's the completed anorak right here, and you can see for the front pocket here, I got out a couple of my old hooded sweatshirts, and I saw how far down their pocket was located, so that's about where I placed the bottom of this pocket. Now, how high I made it was determined by the material that I had cut out from underneath the arm here. Oops. That was one of the cutoffs here, the original blanket. So what I did was I laid it out and I cut this piece off here so it was square. And then I folded it over all the way around each side and sewed it, and then I determined where I wanted to put the pocket on it, and after I had the pocket all hemmed all the way around, I then cut off for the pockets here and folded that under and sewed it as well. So that completed the pocket. Now, before I put it on, the neck hole here, I cut right down from the middle of the neck down to just below where the top of the pocket would be. There you can see how far down I cut. I cut straight down and then cut to the sides. Oh, about half an inch, 3/4 of an inch, 5/8 of an inch or so. Then when I sewed on the pocket, that protected this bottom raw edge from, you know, continuing to unravel and come apart. And then where I slit this, I folded it under and sewed it so that this would not be a raw edge here. And then I used, excuse me, I used a standard grommet kit to put in the grommets here. Okay, when I, on the neck hole here, when I folded that under, I also folded over the excess of the hood front. Remember when we cut out the hood, when we laid out the hood, I marked some excess for the front of the hood. So I folded it over along with it, with the neck hole, and sewed it. That way it's a continuous edge from the neck hole up to the hood. Now I could have put in a grommet right here, another one right here, and put a drawstring in the hood. I did not. I chose not to, but I could have done that if you could do that if you so wish to. All right, that pretty much explains how I made my anorak. Now, let's go try it on, see how it works. Okay, there's the completed anorak. You know, I wanted to make one of these for years, and I just, you know, didn't do it. Well, in watching Neil on Greencraft, the Greencraft channel on YouTube, he inspired me to get with it and try my hand at trying to make one of these. He makes quite a few homemade items on his channel, so if you're interested, check out Greencraft on YouTube. So, I'm pleased with how the length turned out. Now, the size, I'm very pleased with this, how the size turned out as well. It makes me look huge, but you know, that's because of all the gear that I carry in my vest and in the pockets. But it turned out to where it fits quite well and it's not confining or restrictive. The pocket I'm pleased with, it works very well. Plenty enough size to put in like a folding saw. Perhaps a lunch, a sandwich or two. Various things that you might want to carry with you on a short hike. And the neck, I'm pleased with how that turned out as well. See if I can get my beard out of the way here. But this cinches up quite nicely. If it's cold weather, this cinches up, tightens up, and closes this off pretty good. So I'm pleased with the way that turned out. And finally, the hood. All in all, I'm quite pleased with the hood, but one thing I'll probably end up changing eventually is I'll turn the whole thing wrong side out. I'll put it on, and you see this top here, it doesn't quite form fit my head. So I'll pinch this in, mark it, and then I'll sew it and then cut off the excess. That way, the hood, when it's turned right side out, it'll fit much better. Okay, well, thanks for joining me, and we'll see you folks on the next video. You have a good week, and you take care. If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and to share it, as well as subscribe so you don't miss any more. And check out these suggested videos here. Thank you.